So today we are going to study about the liver. So liver, as we know, is the largest gland in the body. Its situation in the body is in the right hypochondrium, the epigastrium, and some part of it lies in the left hypochondrium. So now, coming to the gross anatomy of the liver, as we can see, the liver has five surfaces. This is the anterior surface, this is the superior surface, this is the right surface, this is the posterior surface, and here we have the inferior surface. As we can see, it is only the inferior surface which is most prominent. Rest, all the surfaces are merged with each other. In the liver, there is one prominent border, that is the inferior border, which separates the inferior surface from the anterior surface anterior. Now, as we have seen the surfaces and the borders, now coming to the lobes. The liver basically has two lobes. One is the left lobe and the another one is the right lobe. The left lobe is smaller, it forms 1/6 part of the liver, whereas the right lobe is larger and forms 5/6 part of the liver. Now, coming to the ligaments. The left and the right lobe are basically divided into two parts, anteriorly and superiorly, by the falciform ligament. Posteriorly, as we can see, here we have the attachment of the ligamentum venosum, which is a remnant of ductus venosus. And inferiorly, both the lobes are separated by the ligamentum teres, or the round ligament, which is the remnant of the left umbilical vein. So, now coming to the relations of the individual surfaces. The superior surface is related to the diaphragm, and in the middle there is an impression for the heart, which is the cardiac impression. Anteriorly, the liver is covered by the ribs on the sides, and in the area which lies in the epigastrium, it lies in direct contact with the anterior abdominal wall. The right surface of the liver, we can divide it into three parts. So the upper one third is related to the diaphragm, the pleura, and the lungs. The middle one third is related to the diaphragm, pleura, and the costodiaphragmatic recess, and the lower one third is related only to the diaphragm. Now coming to the posterior surface. As we can see here, the posterior surface, from right to left if we go, first we can see is the triangular bare area. This triangular bare area is basically formed superiorly by the superior coronary ligament, the inferior coronary ligament, and the right triangular ligament. The next here we can see is the caudate lobe. Caudate lobe is one of the smaller lobes, which is considered to be a subdivision of the right lobe. The caudate lobe is bounded on the right side by the groove for inferior vena cava, on the left side by the fissure for ligamentum venosum, and inferiorly by the porta hepatis. And then on the posterior surface, here we are having the impression for the esophagus. So this was about the posterior surface. Now coming to the inferior surface. This surface is considered to be the most important. It is called the visceral surface because it is related to the most of the viscera. So firstly, on the inferior surface, we have the quadrate lobe. See, this one is the quadrate lobe. This is on the right side. This is bounded by the fossa for gallbladder. This is the gallbladder and this is the fossa for gallbladder. On the left side, it is bounded by the fissure for ligamentum teres. Anteriorly, if you will see, take the liver like this, so this is anterior. So anteriorly, it is bounded by the inferior border, and posteriorly, it is bounded by the porta hepatis. Okay. So porta hepatis basically is the point from where all the vessels and ducts enter and exit from the liver. So the structures entering are the portal vein, the hepatic artery, and the hepatic plexus of nerves. And the structures coming out are the right and left bile ducts, as well as the lymphatics. Now, coming to the impressions. So, from the left side, if we will start, here on the posterior surface, we saw there was the impression for the esophagus. So, now here we have a gastric impression for the stomach. Then this is the quadrate lobe. Then we have the gallbladder and the fossa for the gallbladder. Then here, if we will come, there is the colic impression for the colon, and then here we have the impression for the right kidney, and here above we are having the impression for the right suprarenal gland. So this was about the basic gross anatomy. One thing is the bare areas. As we have already seen, one was the bare area on the posterior surface. There are other four bare areas also. One is the groove for inferior vena cava, that is also not covered by peritoneum. Then the fissure for ligamentum venosum, that is also not covered. then the margins of the porta hepatis give attachment to the lesser omentum, hence the porta hepatis is also not covered, and then the fossa for gallbladder, that is also not covered. So these are the five bare areas in the liver which are not covered by the peritoneum. Rest of the liver is covered by the peritoneum. And in the inferior border, if we look, there are two notches present. So this is the interlobar notch, and this notch which we can see here is the cystic notch. So this was about the basic gross anatomy of the liver.